I fell off that. Hello everyone. So we're gonna take EY418 from Abu Dhabi to Kuala Lumpur. See, I'm going back to my own country. And today is July 14th, 2023. So this is a terminal 3 at all the arrivals. This is a terminal 3 at Abu Dhabi. So again, this is quite a busy airport. So it should be a bit, you know, rough, so yeah. Just got past through security. Gate 33 is our gate. Ah, my passport and my ticket here. I'll show you later, guys. So yeah, I'm sitting at row 20. Over there is A6BMC. A 2018 built 787-10. And there's GE NX engines as usual. But it looks nice, you know. I've never flown a dash 10 before, but I've flown a lot of dash 9s in the past. My first time in dash 10, I'm quite excited. Yeah, I prefer 777. But our gate is not bus gate. I'm so glad of that. Anyway, I have to rush back to my gate now. I'm at the gate after this, so let me rush back before, you know, they start boarding. Thomas, stop messaging me at this point. Over there, the other gate over there, my point pointing, there's actually the F1 plane. I can't take a picture of that, they're gonna be way. No, I don't know if them. I really don't know. I don't know. We're gonna board them. Indeed. So, right now I'm in my seat 19A. It's actually sounds familiar, I guess. I think I've been in 19A before in the 779. Also, but I get a massive GNX engine view, so I'm right beside the engine. After you can hear a growl. I'm not sitting business anymore because, you know what, like, it's actually meant for sleeping and eating the cool food, which I'm not gonna even finish in the first place because I hate vegetables. But as you can see, I'm actually alright, you know, because economy is already really good in Etihad, so why would I need business, you know? So it's really nice. 19A is good. It's interesting that they're showing Kuala Lumpur over here. This is the actual city of Kuala Lumpur. I'm from there. I know my city. Alright. So yeah, that's a good flight. So let's do a seat review because this is a 787-10. Might be a few differences. So of course we have our USB port over here, and of course you have your headphone plug, which I do have headphones. So I might plug them in later. Of course you have a tray table over here, which I'm not gonna even open. You know, get in close position. Of course you have a touchscreen, English or Arabic. We'll look at that later, not now. And safety card. Yep, it's in here as well. Your waist bag is also in there. Let's look at the safety card first. And a 787-10. So of course you got your original like safety card. So it's just nothing new. It's just, yeah, it's just what it is. And, well, my ticket's in there, so it's all from internet. So yeah. Oh well, hey, nothing's bad. Nothing's bad, you know. At least I have a headrest. It's premium. It's premium economy, so that's pretty why. I'm sure you've heard this here, no headrest here, but you can just lean on the window. No problem at all. The seat itself is very comfortable. I do like the texturing. And the seat is just brilliant. And as well. So overall, really good seat for me. For premium economy.
With me, second officer Abdullah, sitting for some 7 hours. Weather on the generally fine. However, we're going to spend some turbulence on the way. Once again, try to start out listening to follow the book and take us without this. Many thanks. Congrats.
Okay, it's been moved, so we're about to push back. I'll push him back now.
Maybe there's no
in the open.
personal items under the seat in front of you. Laptops and other larger electronic devices must be switched off and secured for takeoff and landing. Handheld electronic devices such as mobile phones must now be switched off or set to flight mode. If your electronic device is damaged, overheats, or falls into your seat, do not attempt to move your seat. Call one of our cabin crew for immediate assistance. Make sure that your seatbelt is securely fastened, your seat back is upright, your handset and tray table are put away, and the windows are clear. Our cabin crew will now pass through the cabin to carry out a final check. We thank you for your attention and hope you have a good flight.
Movies, Avatar, watch that, all these, watch that.
Wick, not watch, but not gonna watch it. Puss in Boots: Last Wish. I'm waiting for Ruby Gilman to release. Actually, Ruby Gilman should be released here right now. I haven't watched that thing yet, and I really want to watch it. Mission Impossible is probably most like the one that people are gonna watch because it's the one that Etihad sponsors. Yeah, Mission Impossible. DC, Disney, Asian cinema. Let's go to the Asian cinema. I want to see what's in the Asian cinema. Oh, okay. Anything Japanese stuff? Of course not. Okay. Let's look at Chinese. Bollywood on my Chinese. Well, it's about Bollywood. Just that.
الى الوصول الى الشركه.
sometimes it can just be pre-dimmed
by the flight crew. That is what really upsets me.
And of course, dimming the window, it's literally like, it takes 2 minutes. It takes like 4 minutes just to get it full, so I can't wait. Anyway, this is Mecca. Announcement still in progress. Okay. No. Why is it still an announcement?
Just coming.
What did he have to announce? What are they even announcing? It's like playing a football match or something. Commence. I don't know what commence. Oh, that's commence. Okay. I see now. Shoot your good morning. Still have a stuck screen. This morning, the sun is blaring, but fully tinted. So yeah, the window tints with brown, looks almost perfect. And yeah, kind of woken up late, so they are serving a breakfast meal now. It's about 2 hours until we land, and it's sandwich. I didn't take it because I don't like sandwiches. So. Yeah. still have that. And my model is not high level. Right away, we come to the old aero train tracks, which are not operational. Right now, you have to take a bus. There's no train anymore until the new trains come. So that's a bit sad, you know? But I did have one last chance, like 2022, for the aero train. So that's a big W for me. The aero train is just left abandoned here. This is an interesting one, isn't it? There's an orange one to strip out like the orange livery. So it's interesting. It's sad the aero train is dead. We have to wait. Oh, it's very nice though, I can say. Since it's not operational, we're taking the bus, which is actually quite inconvenient. It's a high floor bus, there's steps. It's not, you know, friendly. It's like wheelchair friendly, so yeah. Sorry to say. Oh, look at that. I'm gonna go home, so that camera never gets old, man. So guys, please, I thank you for watching this video. Please give it a like and also subscribe for our channel for more content in Malaysia, because I might not do many in the next coming years, unfortunately, but I really want to, because I love Malaysia so much. So yeah, see you guys.